In this morning's Woman's Doctor, there's a special treatment for liver and pancreatic cancers. It's called NanoKnife, and it kills cancer cells. The advanced system doesn't rely on heat. Instead, it uses a more natural method that destroys only targeted tissue, and that spares critical structures, including vessels, nerves, and ducts. Mercy Medical Center Dr. Debashish Bose says that after a patient undergoes chemotherapy and radiation, surgeons are able to treat tumors using the NanoKnife system. And Dr. Bose is joining us now this morning with some more information. Good morning, Dr. Bose. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great. This is so interesting, and it doesn't rely on heat. So how does it work?
So NanoKnife creates an electric field. So you basically place electric probes around and in the tumor that you're targeting, and an electric field is created that creates holes in the cell membranes. And cells are like little bags of fluid and proteins and DNA. And when those holes occur, the cell can't keep what's outside out and what's inside in. And so it loses its ability to function. And that engages what's called the cell's sort of suicide program called apoptosis. And that means the cell is just going to say, okay, I can't stay alive anymore. I'm going to go ahead and let myself go. And that cell then dies. And then our body's immune system comes in and cleans up the debris, so to speak. So that is a way of causing cell death without burning those cells or freezing those cells, which means that you can treat around blood vessels and bile ducts and pancreatic ducts and things like that, so that those structures remain intact and in place. So that opens up the possibility for us to treat tumors that we otherwise wouldn't have much more than the radiation and chemotherapy to do.
It actually sounds really amazing. And in our story, we talked about it's being used for liver and pancreatic cancer, but why can't you use this technology for other types of cancers like breast cancer?
That's a great question. It is being explored for prostate cancer. In Europe, there have been some small studies to try and use it for breast cancer. I think right now the impetus to use it is a little bit driven by the logistics of getting through FDA approvals and doing all the right studies and tests and trials that get us to those approvals. As we've all learned about getting vaccines to approval, treatments that are new often require a lot of lead time before they're approved for certain kinds of treatment.
But NanoKnife has to be pretty exciting for you as a doctor to be able to treat your patients.
It sure is. It means that we have an option after patients who otherwise have kind of run through the treatments that are conventionally offered to offer something in addition. And so far, the evidence suggests that it does help in terms of overall survival, as well as local treatment or local control of a tumor. In the liver, it opens up the possibility for us to spare more of the liver when we're trying to take away tumors that are in the liver, sometimes if there are multiple tumors. In the pancreas, it means that patients who otherwise wouldn't be candidates for removal of the tumor or more local treatment of the tumor can undergo a surgery. In highly selected patients, this is possible. There are certainly trials ongoing now in pancreas, and we are looking at that in a more rigorous scientific method, but those will take some time to sort of mature and come to conclusions.
All right, Dr. Bose, very exciting and very hopeful. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Really appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me. Have a great day.
You too. And if you have any other questions or you'd like a referral, just call 1-800-MD-MERCY.